In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good morning. Welcome to St. Andrew's Church, Rushmere, for this Holy Eucharist. The Church of which we belong designates today as the day of thanksgiving for the institution of the Holy Communion, Corpus Christi. And so, it is great to have you here. And as we join that great celebration to remember Jesus and his promises to meet with us around the common table. Of course, this year, we can't physically be together. But as I offer this Eucharist for you, we pray together as we meet Jesus, our Saviour, and pray for a spiritual communion. And now we join the choir of Norwich Cathedral to sing Jesus, the Bread of Angels.
Thank you.
as we look for a time when we will be able to meet around the common table, let us give thanks and pray for the tentative reopening of our churches for private prayer. We also remember before God those who are still affected by the coronavirus. Gracious God, we pray that you would protect those in our world who are most vulnerable to the coronavirus. We lift up all who are still suffering, especially those without access to good medical care. We pray they and we would know your peace, your comfort, and your protection. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Be sure to subscribe, to press the like icon, and get in touch if you have any special prayer requests. We would love to include you in our services. And now, we make our prayer of preparation. Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. As we prepare to celebrate the mystery of God's love, revealed in word and sacrament, we take a moment of silence to call to mind our sins. Like a heart longs for flowing streams, so longs my soul for you, O God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
O send out your light and your truth, that they may lead me. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
May we come to your altar, O God, the God of our salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the God of love and power forgive you and free you from your sins, heal and strengthen you by his Spirit, and raise you to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. We respond to God's forgiveness by singing the Gloria.
Seated at the right hand of the
And so we take a moment to gather our thoughts, our prayers, those we bring with us in our hearts. And the collect for Corpus Christi. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you that in this wonderful sacrament you have given us the memorial of your passion. Grant us so to reverence the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may know within ourselves and show forth in our lives the fruits of your redemption. For you are alive and reign with the Father and the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Meg reads the first lesson from Genesis.
And King Melchizedek of Salem brought out bread and wine. He was priest of God Most High. He blessed him and said, Blessed be Abraham by God Most High, maker of heaven and earth. And blessed be God Most High, who has delivered your enemies into your hand. And Abraham gave him one-tenth of everything. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, he took the cup also after supper, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Picking up the words of the confession, we sing a favourite hymn of many, As the Deer Pants for the Water.
You are alone.
Alleluia, alleluia. I am the bread of life that comes down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever.
Alleluia.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Jews, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give for the life of the world is my flesh. The Jews then disputed amongst themselves, saying, how can this man give us his flesh to eat? So Jesus said to them, very truly I tell you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood have eternal life, and I will raise them up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, not like that which your ancestors ate, and they died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
It couldn't be anywhere else, could it? May I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Often, people comment on my journey from the Salvation Army to the Anglican Church, asking what prompted me to make the move. The easy answer, and the catalyst, I suppose, is the celebration of the Eucharist, as each successive Holy Week spoke to me louder and louder. Do this in remembrance of me. I couldn't see myself not having this sacrament central to my life of faith. Since Christianity began, Holy Communion, Eucharist, or the Mass, whatever you prefer to call it, has been central to Christian worship. We know from the Acts of the Apostles that the earliest followers of Jesus regularly met to share bread. The reading from the New Testament Meg just read succinctly recounts the events of the Last Supper. There are two feasts in the liturgical calendar that invite us to meditate on the mystery of the Eucharist. Maundy Thursday and the feast of the precious body and blood of Jesus, Corpus Christi. The celebration of Maundy Thursday reminds us that the Eucharist is a sacrificial meal. But for many, the commemoration of the institute of the Eucharist on Holy Thursday tends to be overshadowed, understandably, by thoughts of the fate that awaits Jesus the following day, Good Friday. One of the advantages of having a separate feast, Corpus Christi, is that it enables the Eucharist to be set in the wider scriptural context. It begins with this exquisite reading from Genesis of a strange priest, the king of Salem, by the name of Melchizedek, and his meeting with Abraham after he fought with the kings in the valley to rescue his nephew Lot. Melchizedek brought bread and wine from Salem to supply the exhausted warrior. I think it's fair to say that central to the scriptural context of the Eucharist is the tradition of the Israelites being fed during their Sinai wandering by the bread from heaven, God's gift of the manna. That brings us to the long sequence that makes up chapter 6 of the fourth gospel, which relates the theme of the manna as bread from heaven to the Christian Eucharist. It doesn't do it immediately, however. It's only towards the end, in fact, in the passage that we've just read, that the discourse becomes explicitly Eucharistic, in the sense of referring directly to the sacrament of the body and blood of Christ. Before this, Jesus speaks of himself as the bread of life in a more general sense, one of high Christological significance. He senses that the people want him to emulate Moses, their great father, who arranged for bread, the manna, to be given to their ancestors from heaven. They wanted some of that. The comparison with Moses is something Jesus refuses entirely. He's not just another Moses-like figure turning on miracles for the people. The true point of comparison is the manna. He is the true bread from heaven. The original manna sustained the Israelites only for a time, after which, in due course, they died. Whereas this bread of heaven is eternal life. Union with Christ and the revelation of God, he will communicate, as in communion, a share of the eternal life of God. It is in this sense that Jesus says, anyone who eats this bread will live forever. The original manna was a gift from God to sustain the Israelites on their journey through the wilderness. This new bread from heaven is a gift from God in a more remarkable way. Jesus describes the bread that he will give as my flesh for the life of the world. Amen. In medieval times, there used to be wonderful processions in which the consecrated elements were taken out of the church and processed on the streets, showing that the Word made flesh was not just in the box labelled church, but in our midst, just as he was on the streets of Nazareth and Jerusalem. I think this image is so poignant this year, when the box labelled church has been firmly shut, yet Jesus has been seen in the streets, in the ICU, in the helping hands of neighbours, and in the phone calls and prayers. Let us pray. We come boldly to the throne of grace, praying to Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, for mercy and grace, whose love profound a ransom for souls has found. We pray for the world created by your love, for its nations and governments. Extend to them your peace, pardoning love, mercy and grace. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Almighty Son, incarnate Word, our prophet, priest, redeemer, Lord, we pray for the church created for your glory, for its ministry to reflect those works of yours. Extend to us your salvation, growth, mercy and grace. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Eternal Spirit, by whose breath the soul is raised from sin and death, we pray for families and individuals created in your image, for the lonely, the bereaved, the sick and dying. we hold before you all those for whom we pray. Among them, Janet, Ellen, Janet, Evelyn and Ted, Ruth, Roger and Mary, Doreen, Janice, Matthew, Tom, Betty, June, David and Pam, and Nafat. Breathe on them the breath of life and bring them to your mercy and grace. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus, the bread of life, we pray for all who have died in recent days, holding before you Daphne Cutting, baby Charlie, baby Lambert, baby Day, baby Deverell, Harold Pleasance, and William Catt. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Through the mystery of your grace, O Lord, we pray for ourselves, for your church, for all who we remember before you, bringing us all to bow before your throne in heaven, to receive life and pardon, mercy and grace for all eternity, as we worship you, saying, Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. During the singing of this next hymn, Sweet Feast of Love Divine, we would usually take up the offering and I would say a prayer. I want to thank you again for your continued financial support of St. Andrew's. May God bless the gifts we offer, the givers, and may we all be used as we share in God's mission here in Rushmere.
Sweet feast of love divine, 'tis grace that makes us free to feed upon this bread and wine in memory, Lord, of thee. Hear every welcome guest waits, Lord, from thee to learn the secrets of thy Father's breast and all thy grace discern. Here conscience ends its strife and faith delights to prove the sweetness of the bread of life, the fullness of thy love, that blood that flowed for sin in symbol here we see, and feel the blessed pledge within that we are loved of thee. Oh, if this glimpse of love is so divinely sweet, what will it be, O Lord, above thy gladdening smile to me, to see thee face to face, thy perfect likeness wear, and all thy ways of wondrous this glimpse of love is so divinely sweet. What will it be, O Lord, above thy gladdening smile to me, to see thee face to face, thy perfect likeness wear, and all thy ways of wondrous grace through endless years declare.
We are the body of Christ. In one spirit, we are baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that makes for peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a virtuous sign of peace. Peace be with you. God, our sustainer, receive the gifts we bring before you, and feed us continually with that bread which satisfies all hunger, your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right. It is our duty and our joy, at all times and in all places, to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now we give you thanks, because by water and the Holy Spirit you have made us a holy people. In Jesus Christ our Lord, you renew that mystery of bread and wine to show forth your glory in all the world. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. You gave your only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. He instituted, and in his holy gospel, commanded us to continue a perpetual memory of his precious death until he comes again. Hear us, merciful Father, we humbly pray, and grant that, by the power of your Holy Spirit, we receive in these gifts of your creation, this bread and this wine, according to your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, Lord and Heavenly Father, in remembrance of the precious death and passion, the mighty resurrection and glorious ascension of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, we offer you, through him, this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Grant that, by his merits and death, and through faith in his blood, we and all your church may receive forgiveness of our sins and all other benefits of his passion, although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer you any sacrifice. Yet we pray that you will accept this, the duty and service that we owe. Do not weigh our merits, but pardon our offences, and fill us all who share in this holy communion with your grace and heavenly blessing. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Looking for the coming of his kingdom, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread.
Jesus is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Let us join together in a prayer for our spiritual communion. Heavenly Father,
As we participate with your people in these holy mysteries, we pray you now to grant your gift of spiritual communion with trust in your faithfulness and your abiding love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
We do not presume
to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen.
Praise to you, our God and Father, for you have fed us with the bread of heaven and quenched our thirst from the true vine. Hear our prayer, that being grafted into Christ, we may grow together in unity and feast with him in his kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May God the Father, who fed his children with manna in the wilderness, strengthen you in your pilgrimage to the promised land.
Amen.
May God the Son, who gave his flesh for food and his blood for drink, keep you in eternal life and raise you up on the last day.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit, who leads us in all truth, help you discern the Lord's body and empower you to proclaim his death until he comes.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you, those you love, and those who love you today and until Jesus comes or calls.
Amen.
I was conflicted about what should be our final hymn this morning. I'm sorry if you have Welsh blood. I didn't choose that one. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry, and whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.